Sexism in Indian ads. Indian society has always been sexist in some or the other ways and has restricted and targeted the role of women in society.
Today's video is about such classic examples of sexism in advertisement and campaigns carried out by government and private companies.
In one of the posters of Beti Bachao Beti Padhao campaign started by the ruling party, the ad reads, कैसे खाओगे तुम उनके हाथ की रोटियां जब पैदा ही नहीं होने दोगे बेटियां। आर वुमेन बॉर्न ओनली टू कुक फूड एंड मेक रोटीज। दिस एड रीइंफोर्सेस द आइडिया दैट वुमेन बिलोंग ओनली इन द किचन। स्निकर्स एड हैज एन कंटेंशियस टैगलाइन। भूख लगने पे तू लड़की बन जाता है। दिस एड स्टेट्स दैट गर्ल्स आर अनोइंग नो मैटर व्हाट।
Another ad about vaginal tightening cream,
which states that it will make one feel like a virgin again to give more pleasure to a husband. This ad is all about the men's needs and has nothing to do with the woman. The ads for deodorant and body sprays have attained another level of sexism, where objectification is on its epitome. Similarly, the car ads never show a female driver or owner, but a beautiful girl will always be there in the poster. In a recent advertisement for Jack and Jones, Ranveer Singh is shown carrying a female co-workers, saying, "Don't hold back, take your work home." This ad is not only derogatory to women but also justifies sexual harassment at workplace. Move, being one of the oldest brands, has always shown a typical housewife doing her daily household work while her husband watches TV. When she hurts her back, she applies Move and gets back to the household work. The ad ends with placing no responsibility on the man for household chores.
Kellogg's Special K ad body shames women in a very subtle manner. Society has always associated women with thin body and this ad supports it. People are so much concerned about their bodies that they develop depression. Ads like this reinforce such ideas.
Diapers. The year is
2020
and we still don't have an advertisement that will show a dad changing the diapers even once. But there is still some hope. Some very progressive brands are breaking stereotypes. Ariel's Share the Load campaign asked the viewers that is laundry only a woman's job? Nirma has recently made Hrithik Roshan as their brand ambassador, and Tanishq ad, where the ad normalizes the idea of a woman getting remarried, are a few of the ads which have come as a breath of fresh air. Media houses can be urged to think about public sensitivity before using any potentially sexist or offensive matters in the ads. Recently, Britain has joined countries like Belgium, France, Finland, Greece, Norway and South Africa, which have laws or codes of varying degrees and age that prevent gender discrimination in ads. Norway, for example, has had a law prohibiting sexism in ads since 1978. A 2004 Spanish law against gender violence prohibits ads from showing degrading images of a woman's body, and Australian courts consider depiction that reduce a person to their sexuality discriminatory. When Meghan Markle spoke at the United Nations in 2015 as a UN ambassador for women's rights, she spoke about the time when she called out to the makers of a sexist ad. At the age of 11, she saw an advertisement for Dish Soap with the slogan, "Women all over America are fighting greasy pots and pans." The company took note of a letter and replaced the word "woman" with "people." We should not stand by and watch the ads that perpetuates gender stereotypes. Celebrities should refuse to star in sexist ads and take a stronger stand to set an example for the society. Moreover, as responsible individuals, we can refuse to buy these products or services. Please tell us in your comments if we have missed any Indian ad that perpetuates gender stereotype and how do you think it should be curbed.